Hi friends, in this video we are going to learn introduction of memory management in operating systems. So memory management is very important topic in operating systems. In this video we are going to cover background, protection, hardware address translation, multi-step processing of a user program, logical versus physical address space, memory management unit. First we will see background. So background in the sense, it's a kind of prerequisite for learning the memory management system. So here we need to understand certain points. First point is, program must be brought into memory and placed within a process for it to run or to be run. Means, for every program, we know the program stored in the hard disk. If you want to run that program, the stored program brought from the hard disk and it is loaded into the memory. Memory means here primary memory, RAM. Then it generates a process. So running program is called a process, we know. But running program means the program is loaded into the main memory. So all the work is happening, all the instructions are carried out, all the instructions are done in primary memory only. That is the important point we need to understand. Main memory and registers are only storage, CPU can access directly. So when you talk about memory, there are different memories available in our computer. Main memory, registers, cache memory and secondary storage memory, secondary devices or secondary memory. And among these, CPU can access directly main memory and registers and also cache memory also. It cannot directly access the secondary memory. Means, whenever you want to access data from the secondary memory, through main memory only CPU can get the data. Or if CPU sends any data to the secondary memory, through primary memory only it sends the data. And the next point here is, register access is done in one CPU clock. So every CPU has clock speed. Accessing data or instructions available in the register is happening in one clock cycle. Means very short span of time, CPU can access the content in registers. Main memory can take many cycles. When compared to accessing registers data, accessing main memory data is somehow large. Cache sits between main memory and CPU registers. We know cache, there is a cache memory where you can store the frequently used instructions. It places in between the primary memory and CPU registers. So in this background we learn how the program is loaded into the memory and why it is called a process, where it loaded, from where to where, and what are the different memories available and accessing speed of different memories from the CPU. So you can easily understand these points by using the diagram. So here there is a CPU and registers are always available within the CPU, the processor having the registers. And primary memory and cache memory. Cache memory is placed in between CPU and primary memory and the secondary memory. So secondary memory cannot access directly by the CPU. Through primary memory, the secondary memory data is accessed. So accessing registers is fast from the processor and accessing cache data is somehow fast when compared to primary memory. Here this is the first one and this is the second one and this is the third one. So these three memory areas can be accessed by the CPU directly. Among those, fastest access is from registers. Second one is cache, third one is primary. So secondary memory cannot be accessed by CPU directly. It can be accessed through primary memory only. So these points you should remember. Next, here the concept is protection. So we know in memory there are different processes are available. Including these processes, operating system is also available. So we know at the time of booting, the part of the operating system is loaded into the memory. So your primary memory, this is primary memory in the sense, this is RAM. In RAM, operating system is occupied, some part of the operating system, and the remaining part is occupied by the different process. And how process was assigned to the memory addresses and how these addresses are protected, that we need to discuss here. So need to ensure that a process can access only those addresses in its address space. So there are different processes. Each process can access its own address space only. Let us say this is process 1. Process 1 can access the address space from 420940 to 8840. So this area, this is the address space of the process 1. And for process 2, the address space is from here to here. This is process 3. Process 3 address space is from here to here. Protection can be provided by using a pair of base and limit registers. These two are very, very important for establishing the protection mechanism. These are two registers, base and base plus limit. So the base register refers the starting of the process address. Here you observe P2 is the process. Here the base value is 34040. This is the base value. That means this process address space starting from this address and up to 420940. So this is base plus limit. In between these, this process can access. That is the address space concept of the process which can be accessed. So here there are three different processes, each process having its own address space. So P1 cannot interact with the address space of P2. P2 cannot interact with the address space of P3. This way, protection can be implemented. Now we can easily understand the process of doing the protection. So here you can observe. CPU must check every memory access generated in user mode to be sure it is between base and limit for that user. Means here CPU checking each and every address, whether the address is available within the base and base plus limit value by using some hardware implementation. For example, CPU checking the address is if greater than or equal to the base address, then it goes for further checking mechanism. Here it checks the address is less than base plus limit value, then it can be accessible. Now it can be accessible. For example, it's a P1. And if that address is greater than or equal to base value, but not less than base plus limit value, then it send to trap. And also if that address is less than base value, again it send to the operating system as a trap. Then the operating system handle that situation. That means here each and every instruction, for each and every instruction, CPU checks the address is within the base and base plus limit address space or not. So the instructions to loading the base and limit registers are privileged. Means for every address handling, for accessing every address area in memory, CPU must check whether the address is accessible for process or not, whether the address is within the limitation of that address space or not. In this way, protection mechanism can be implemented. So next we will understand processing of a user program. So we know there are different programs available in the hard disk. If you run any program, that program is turned as a process. Until that we know. But in between the program to process, there are different steps, different stages. We need to understand those stages. For example, here the source program, I am taking a simple C program. Let us say some p1 dot c is my program, p1 dot c, or you can take p1 dot java also. So p1 dot c is my program, which is available in hard disk. That is my source program. When I want to execute this program, first this program is compiled, because without the compilation, operating system cannot understand this program. So here the first process is compilation. Compilation or interpretation, whatever is, depends on the compiler or interpreter, we can do that thing. So here first p1.c is compiled and it generates object module. Generally this is called obj file in case of C program, .obj. So your source program is compiled into object program or object module. So this time is called compile time. Then this object module is going to linker process, linker program. Linker program gets this object module and it adds if any other object modules are added or not. If there is any other object modules has to be added, it added, and this process is called linking. So our source program is generated as an object module, and that object module, if there is any already predefined object modules are needed for our program, those are added by the linker. Then that file is going to load module. So the load module adds the system library files. That means there is a program called loader. This loader adds the system library files. For example, your p1.c having any system library files, you are using any system libraries, those are added. The code for those library files are added at the time of loading. And this loader finally loads your p1.c program, converted p1.c program, into memory. Until this, the time is called load time. So first one is compile time, then next one is load time. So here the linking process and loading process is happening. After loading, your program is converted into a process available in the memory, primary memory. This is called execution time. In that execution time, if there is any dynamically loaded system library files needed, those are loaded. If any runtime memory generated functions are used, or malloc, calloc functions, for those variables memory was generated. At the compilation time, if you try to write int a in your program, let us say there is int a is available. For this a, the memory was generated at the compile time. If there is any pointer variable or taken and use some malloc or calloc functions, for those variables memory was allocated at execution time. So these times you should know. This is a processing of a user program. Initially it is a program available in the hard disk. When you try to execute, the program is transformed into different stages. Finally the program is loaded into the main memory, and we call it as a process in the main memory. Within that main memory, that process is executing step by step, then we will get the output of the particular program. This is all about processing of a user program. Next concept is logical versus physical address space. So logical address means it was generated by the CPU. Also it is referred to as virtual address. either logical address or virtual address, you can call it any way, but this address was generated by the CPU. Physical address, this address seen by the memory unit. This address seen by the memory unit. Logical and physical addresses are the same in compile time and load time address binding schemes. So whatever the addresses, logical and physical, both are same in compile time and load time address binding schemes. Address binding is happening at two stages. One is load time address time binding, compile time address time binding, and another one is also there, that is called execution time address binding or runtime address binding. Total three address time bindings. So this logical and physical addresses are the same in compile time and load time address binding schemes, and these two are differ in execution time address binding scheme. So we have two address space, one is logical and another one is physical. Logical address was generated by the CPU. Physical address was observed or seen by the memory unit. So the physical address is available in the main memory. The memory where the process is stored, that address space is called physical address space. Logical address space was generated by the CPU. These two addresses or address space are same at compilation time and load time, but these are differ in execution time binding. Now we can understand what is exactly the difference between these two addresses and how the mapping happening between these two addresses. So here you can observe there is a dedicated hardware device, we call it as memory management unit. This memory management unit maps the logical address generated by the CPU with the physical address available in the memory. So there is a dedicated memory management unit. That memory management unit responsibility is it gets the logical address generated by the CPU and convert it to the physical address available in the memory. So here you have to understand a point. The memory address available in the RAM is not understandable or not accessed directly by the CPU. CPU generate logical address, main memory unit maps this address to the available address. This is one type of security mechanism. Now we can take a simple scheme so that we can easily understand how exactly this mapping is happening. See, here there is a CPU. CPU generates a logical address. Let us say this is 346. And there is a relocation register. Also, we termed it as base register also. Base register having a value 1400. So this is available in the main memory unit. So the CPU generated address is sent to the main memory unit. Main memory unit having the relocation register value. This value is available in the memory. It continuously, main memory unit continuously monitor the memory for available address space, and it is updated with the available address space. So this 346 plus this 14000, 14346 generated by the main memory unit, that is called physical address space. On that address space the instruction is stored, or on that address space the data or the instruction available is accessed by the CPU. Okay, so the CPU generate one logical address. That logical address is added with the relocation register value available in the main memory unit. Finally, the combined value is our physical address space available in the memory. So the value in the relocation register is added to every address generated by a user process at the time it is sent to memory. Why this is also one kind of security mechanism, because in memory user processes are available and some kernel mode processors are available. So process can be of two types. Process can be run at user mode and process can be run at kernel mode. Okay, so no user process interact with the kernel mode processor. For that we need to maintain this base register and limitation values also. This is one kind of security mechanism. And one thing is, CPU always generates addresses which are not available in the memory. Those addresses are called logical addresses. How we can access, how we can get that particular memory location means by using the relocation register, which is available in the main memory unit. So here the main memory unit responsibility is, it always monitor the memory where the memory block is available. It is updated the relocation register with that value. So that value is added to the logical address generated by the CPU, so that the memory location is available for the particular process. The data is accessed in the memory. So this is about the main memory management unit in main memory. So this is all about the introduction concepts of the memory management units. Thank you.